Please rise as we sing together the great Reformation Day hymn, "A Mighty Fortress Is Our God." The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated.
We welcome you all in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, to this very special service of the Confirmation of Faith. Welcome to extended family and friends who have come to support our confirmants at this most important milestone in their lives of faith. We ask that you would continue to keep them in your prayers as they move from this milestone forward in their faith lives. Special thank you to everyone who makes these special services possible, from our musicians to acolytes to ushers, all who are involved. We appreciate everyone who makes it possible for us to celebrate in this way. Following the service, confirmants and their families are welcome to take pictures, come back into the sanctuary or in other places in the church. And then note you also, each confirmant has a flower that you can take home. So be sure to do that. Take the flower, leave your robe at the end of the service, okay? When we get to the individual confirmation of faith, as a family are invited forward, we would ask you to come up the center aisle to surround your confirmant, but return to the side aisles. It just helps prevent a lot of congestion as a lot of people are going back and forth. The offering that will be given during the service has been designated by our confirmants to the Phase 2 capital campaign that we are running, hoping to complete our building project in the future. So our thanks to them for that dedication. Most of what you need for the service is in the bulletin and also, as you've seen, on the screens. But at this time, I invite you to rise and to share the peace of Christ with one another as we turn to the brief order for confession and forgiveness. Baptized into the death of Christ, we begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. 1 John chapter 1 declares that if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But that if we confess our sin, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive us and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And so, clinging to that promise, let us together, in a moment of silence, confess before God whatever sin or guilt or shame weighs on our hearts this day. Most merciful God, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for you, and for his sake God forgives you all your sin. To those who believe in Jesus Christ, he gives the power to become the children of God and bestows on them the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray together the prayer of the day. O God, our Heavenly Father, you see your children growing up in an uncertain and confusing world. Show them that your ways give more life than the ways of the world, and that following you is better than chasing after the things of this world. As these young people confirm their Christian faith, strengthen and uphold them, that they may cling to your word in life and in death, fear nothing except losing you, and follow in confident trust wherever you may lead them.
through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. Amen.
This first reading this afternoon is Psalms 46. This Psalms, which inspired Martin Luther to write our opening hymn, "A Mighty Fortress Is Our God," reminds God's people that even though the world around you might be full of chaos, God is still God. God is in control. Reading from the book of Psalms. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult, there is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of the city. It shall not be moved. God will help it when the morning dawns. The nations are in uproar. The kingdoms totter. He utters his voice. The earth melts. The Lord of the hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come, behold the works of the Lord. See what desolations he has brought on the earth. He makes wars cease at the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shield with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The second reading this afternoon is from Paul's letter to the Ephesians, chapter 4, verses 1 through 6 and 14 through 16. The Apostle Paul, in this letter to the Ephesians, encourages them to live a life worthy of their calling, to grow up and stand firm in their faith, letting it shine through them and benefit the church. Reading from Ephesians. I therefore, the prisoner in the Lord, beg you to lead a life worthy of the calling to which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, making every effort to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, just as you are called to the one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. Continuing with verse 14, we must no longer be children, tossed to and fro and blown about by every wind of doctrine, by people's trickery, by their craftiness and deceitful scheming. But speaking the truth in love, we must grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ from whom the whole body, joined and knit together by every ligament with which it is equipped, as each part is working properly, promotes the body's growth and building itself up in love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, girls. Please stand as you're able for the reading of the gospel. The holy gospel for this confirmation Sunday is from Mark chapter 10, beginning in verse 46. They came to Jericho. As Jesus and his disciples and a large crowd were leaving Jericho, Bartimaeus, son of Timaeus, a blind beggar, was sitting by the roadside. When he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout out and say, "Jesus, Son of God, have mercy on me." Many sternly ordered him to be quiet, but he cried out even more loudly, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus stood still and said, "Call him here." And they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take heart. Get up, he's calling you." So throwing off his cloak, he sprang up and came to Jesus. Then Jesus said to him, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man said to him, "My teacher, let me see again." Jesus said to him, "Go, your faith has made you well." Immediately he regained his sight and followed him on the way. The Gospel of the Lord. You may be seated. confirmation students, family, sponsors, mentors, guides, and friends. Grace to you and peace from God our Heavenly Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. You made it. You made it. Here you are, looking good in your white robes, family and friends by your side. You did it. I have to admit, some of you, I kind of had some doubts. I don't know. I'm just kidding. You guys have been a great class. So now what? Now that you're done with all of the work, the worship notes, the acolyting, the Wednesday classes, the retreats, the memorization, now that you are done, now what? As you stand up here in a little bit and make a public profession of your faith, what does that mean? And what do you want Jesus to do for you? Let me tell you about three confirmation students, if you will, that had to answer that question. Jimmy, Johnny, and Bart. Jimmy and Johnny were brothers, and they were pretty good confirmation students. John actually took some really good sermon notes. And they were pretty bold in their faith, maybe even a little too bold at times, because they demanded some pretty outlandish things. Teacher, they said, we want you to do whatever we ask of you. Now, in this case, the teacher was not me or Pastor Scott. It was a much better teacher, if you can believe that. Because this teacher was Jesus. Johnny and Jimmy, or James and John, as the Gospel of Mark refers to them, decided to treat Jesus like the genie in a lamp. Do whatever we want you to do, Jesus. But surprisingly, Jesus does not smite them on the spot. I would have. But instead, he asks them a wide open question. What do you want me to do for you? And Jimmy and Johnny answer with their freaky fast delivery, make our dreams come true. Make us great. Give us the best positions in the kingdom. And Jesus said, you have no idea what you are talking about. Well, fast forward to the end of the chapter where our gospel reading comes from. It's there that we meet our third confirmation student, Bart. Bart wasn't as good of a confirmation student, but it wasn't necessarily his fault. He had some pretty significant learning disabilities. Namely, he couldn't see. He was blind. But like James and John, Bart also had a request. So he called out to Jesus. And it says the disciples tried to get him to be quiet. I wonder, was it Johnny and Jimmy? But Jesus said, call him over. So the disciples, again, maybe Johnny and Jimmy here, went to him and said, take heart, get up. He's calling to you. And they brought him to Jesus. And again, Jesus looked at Bart, or Bartimaeus, as Mark calls him in his gospel. And again, he asks the exact same question. What do you want me to do for you? And Bart says, I want to see. James and John asked for greatness. Bartimaeus asked for help. I'm curious, confirmands, what would you ask Jesus to do? What do you want Jesus to do for you? Now that you're done with all of your confirmation requirements, how does Jesus fit in to your lives. What do you want from him? Now, in the past, I've seen confirmation students profess their faith on confirmation day and then basically tell Jesus to go stand in the corner over there. Thanks for getting me through confirmation, Jesus. I appreciate it. Now, if you could just go stand over there and be quiet, well, that'd be great. And I've got a lot of high school on my plate right now. Too much fun and temptation. But it's cool. You know, we can hang out every once in a while, like maybe on Christmas and Easter or something like that. But in the meantime, hold tight. That's what I want you to do for me. Of course, I've also seen the Johnny and Jimmy genie Jesus strategy. Jesus, I've got big dreams, and I need you to make them all come true for me. So I need you to keep me away from all pain and disappointment. I need you to approve of all my decisions, even and especially the bad ones. And I want you to make me happy and successful all of the time. You do your part, Jesus, and I'll wear a cross necklace. That's what I want you to do for me. Of course, then there's also the in case of emergency, Jesus, right? Hey, Jesus, I've got things pretty much under control right now. I really don't need you, you know, interfering in my life. But, you know, if something goes wrong, you know, well, then you better be there. You know, you're good for now. But if someone gets sick, or my girlfriend dumps me, or if I haven't studied for a test, well, then I'm counting on you. That's what I need you to do for me. Now, there are probably several more examples there, and at one time or another, I've been guilty of several of them. I'm guessing you have been too. But here's the deal. Jesus doesn't really follow directions very well. He doesn't really, you know, stay in the corner or respect our privacy. He's kind of rude like that. He thinks he knows better. So while you try and regulate him to the corner or to a task or to a certain time, well, he insists on saving you. But he says, follow me. The Apostle Paul, in his letter to the Ephesians, put it this way. Lead a life worthy of the calling to which you have been called. And then he later adds, we must no longer be children. We must grow up in every way into him who is the head, Jesus Christ. When you are confirmed, you are no longer considered a child. You are a full member of Faith Lutheran Church. You could serve on church council, and you can vote in our congregational meeting next month, and we hope that you do. We hope that you won't consider yourself done when it comes to learning and growing in your faith. We hope that you continue to lead a life worthy of the calling to which you have been called, because you are called. My favorite line in this gospel reading is the proclamation that the disciples deliver to Bartimaeus. They go up to him and they say, take heart, he is calling you. You see, Jesus doesn't sit around waiting for us to determine if he's useful or relevant in our lives. Instead, he calls us. And confirmation students, take heart. He is calling you. He is calling you to continue following him, to continue to call on his name, to be still and know that he is God, to grow, to serve, to love, to shine. But even more importantly, He is calling you, like he called Bartimaeus, to have mercy on you. He's calling you to forgive you, to redeem you, and to make you his own. So what do you want Jesus to do for you? Well, what could he do that he hasn't already done for you? First, in your baptism, and even now, it's confirmed you are God's child. Thanks be to God. Amen.
the director of Youth and Family Ministry here, and I've worked closely with our confirmation class. So excited for them. These persons have been instructed in their Christian faith and desire to make public affirmation of their baptism. And I'm going to invite them to stand one by one as I call their names and stay standing. Brody David Adams, Riley Marie Benning, Vincent Aaron Bergstrand, Eli Dean During, Ariana Taylor Flores, Morgan Elizabeth Gerke, Jacob Richard Hansen, Kellen David Karg, Lucas Rodney Leopold, Sydney Anna Danielle Lowe, Brooklyn Ann Merkins, Zachary Eric Paternus, Andrew Valentino Passavento, Aiden Michael Raff, Malia Marie Rood, Annabeth Joan Schiller, Maddox Alexander Schumacher, Lily Rebecca Soline, and Michaela Madison Wakefield.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, in holy baptism, our Lord Jesus Christ received you and made you members of his church. In the church, the community of God's people, you have learned from his word God's loving purpose for you and for all creation. You have been nourished at his holy table and called to be witnesses to the gospel of Jesus Christ. Now, therefore, we ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church, the faith in which we baptize.
Do you renounce all the forces of evil, the devil, and all his empty promises? Do you believe in God the Father? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit? You may be seated. And at this time, we want to thank Zach and Morgan, who are sharing their faith statements on behalf of the rest of the class.
Hello, my name is Morgan. I grew up going to church and Sunday school every Sunday I could. My parents felt strongly that I should be taught how to pray at a young age. This looked like praying before meals and praying with me before bed. I attended King's Kids Preschool. My faith continued to grow throughout my elementary years. I started going to 56ers at Faith in fifth grade, and I liked it. I also went through my first communion here at Faith, which helped me grow as well. But my faith really started to grow when I was in middle school and in confirmation. During middle school, I would have friend problems or anything that would go wrong. I wouldn't know what to do, and I'd go to my mom, and she'd give me advice, and then she'd tell me to say a prayer about it. My big jump started in eighth grade when I learned the big importance of prayer. I used to pray once in a while when I felt like I needed it, but since the beginning of eighth grade, I haven't missed a night of prayer before bed. I put time away, whether it's a few minutes or longer, whether it's just praising and thanking the Lord or asking for guidance and healing. I also spend time reading scriptures. God moves mountains for me every time, and everything he decides for me is for the better, even though at the time it might make you feel like, what is God trying to do to me? God speaks through every struggle. I put my heart to him, and he guided me to the light. He has spoken to me, especially when multiple of my family members have been hospitalized in the last year, when I've been going through friend problems, going through life transitions like moving from the middle school to high school, or my sister going to college. Even during times when I feel like I have no one, I pray for someone to come into my life, even if it's someone like my mom or my sister or any family. He has led me to some very good people I never thought I would have a tight connection with. The Lord has spoken through me through scriptures when I'm looking through my Bible and need guidance. God has helped me in every day of my life. He has led me to verses like my confirmation verse, "For I know the plans I have for you," Jeremiah 29:11. Later on in the chapter, it says, "You will call upon me and come pray to me, and I will hear you. You will seek and find me when you seek and find me with your heart." To me, this verse means that if you put your trust in the Lord, he will direct you in the right path and that God is in control. The verse Jeremiah 29 gives hope and assurance in time and uncertainty. This is a promise that the Lord has plans for us and a reminder that he has purpose for everything in our lives. From friends to family to sports to health, Jesus is my Savior. He means so much to me. The impact he has made really affects everyone to this day. No one would believe him that he was sent from the one and only God. He had to suffer, die, and then rise again so we could live eternally with him. And so he could prove us that he was sent from the one and only God. I see Jesus helping me spread the word to others who don't believe in the Lord yet. I see him healing and guiding me in everything. I plan to continue to put time away each and every day to read the word and pray. I see myself making an impact on others' faith, especially through teaching Sunday school. Confirmation Day means to me confirming that I am a child of God and to put my faith in the Lord. It means that I have eternal life and I will meet the Lord one day in heaven. The Lord guides me and I can see him guiding me through the rest of my life. I will continue to share the gospel for the rest of my life.
Hi, my name is Zach Patternus, and I have always been around the church since I was little. I got baptized and my parents made me go to Sunday school just about every week. I enjoyed Sunday school, but not for the right reasons. I would go because I liked messing around with my friends. In fifth grade, my mom encouraged me to check out 56ers, but my attitude continued in that faith. In sixth grade, my family started regularly coming to faith on Sundays, and I was able to go through first confirmation. Something was different after that, though. I wasn't being as reckless as I was in 56ers, and I wasn't off the walls like I was earlier. I don't really know why that is, but I started paying attention to sermons more. In seventh grade, I started confirmation, and it hit me, and my faith took off from there, and I started to pay more attention to lessons. Lessons were interesting, and I started to grow my faith more than I had before. I started picking up my Bible more and finding verses and writing them down, and I also started to connect with new people I wouldn't have before. The retreats provided me an opportunity to disconnect from my phone and other things that were distractions and be able to focus on topics that were more important. It was a freeing feeling. These 2 years in confirmation were meaningful to me as I was able to dig deeper in my faith. My sister Gina plugged in the fly, and if you know my sister, she's relentless in telling me what to do. So I got signed up for the mission trip and started coming to Fly in May. I was unsure of how I felt at first and was unsure if I even wanted to go on the mission trip, but I powered through and went anyways. We traveled down to Alabama, and I was a bit nervous about the trip, but it ended up being a good thing for me as I was able to make new friends that I did not have before, and I made a lot of new connections. Being away from distractions of friends and home and school, I was able to connect with people and God. The first day of the trip, we went to Bellingrath Gardens and cleared brush out and trees. I saw Jesus and a guy we met in Bellingrath Gardens named Tyler. He shared his life story and a lot of advice that were meaningful to us. The second day of the trip, we went to the cemetery and the food shelf. I saw Jesus in my small group as we worked hard to clean up this place that needed the care. This was here where we got to know a lot about each other and what everyone's strengths and weaknesses are. We also got to hear their stories. On the third day, we were back in the cemetery taking down trees. It was cool to see the progress we were making and how it impacted the community. On the fourth workday, we went to a church and painted and pressure washed concrete. I saw Jesus in our worksite that appreciated our hard work with ice cream. But probably the most meaningful experience for me on the trip was the nighttime traditions. Confession night and affirmation night all impacted me, but it was hard to describe, or it was hard to put in words. This provided me time to get closer with my small group and hear their struggles, which allowed me to feel that we were not alone in our struggles, but rather we have a community that supports us. So for me, getting confirmed today means that I have a community to lean on and feel supported in, and that it will push me in my faith so I can grow closer to God. I hope to continue to go to youth groups. Now I'm doing it because I enjoy it and not because my sister and parents told me to.
Now, as we invite each confirmant forward individually to confirm their faith, family members can follow the confirmant and gather around them here. Again, we ask you to come up the center aisle, return by the side aisle. And so we begin with Brody.
Brody David Adams. Brody chose Philippians 4:13 as his confirmation verse. I can do all things through him who strengthens me.
Brody David, you have made public profession of your faith. So now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Brody David, whom you've adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and keep him steadfast in your word, that in the end he may be saved and live eternally with you.
Riley Marie Benning. Riley also chose Philippians 4:13 as her verse. I can do all things through him who strengthens me.
Riley Marie, you have made public profession of your faith. So now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Riley Marie, whom you adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and keep her steadfast in your word, that in the end she may be saved and live eternally with you.
Amen.
Amen.
Vincent Aaron Bergstrand. Vincent chose John 3:15 through 16 as his confirmation verse, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life.
Vincent, Aaron, you also have made public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism? And as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Vincent Aaron, whom you've adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and keep him steadfast in your word, that in the end he may be saved and live eternally with you. Amen.
Eli Dean Durian. Eli chose Proverbs 3, verses 5 through 6 as his confirmation verse. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart, and do not rely on your own insight. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will make straight your paths.
Eli Dean, you have made public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Eli Dean, whom you adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and keep him steadfast in your word, that in the end he may be saved and live eternally with you.
Amen. Amen.
Ariana Taylor Flores. Ari chose 1 Corinthians 16:14 as her confirmation verse. Let all that you do be done in love.
Ariana Taylor, you have made public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Ariana Taylor, whom you've adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and keep her steadfast in your word, that in the end she may be saved and live eternally with you.
Morgan Elizabeth Gerke. Morgan chose Jeremiah 29:11 as her confirmation verse. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope.
Morgan Elizabeth. You have made public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Morgan Elizabeth, whom you adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and keep her steadfast in your word, that in the end she may be saved and live eternally with you.
Amen.
Amen.
Jacob Richard Hansen. Jacob chose Colossians 3, verse 17. Whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him.
Jacob Richard, you also have made public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Jacob Richard, whom you've adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and keep him steadfast in your word, that in the end he may be saved and live eternally with you. Amen.
Kellen David Carg. Kellen chose Isaiah 41, verse 10. So do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand.
Kellen David, you have made public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Kellen David, whom you adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and keep him steadfast in your word, that in the end he may be saved and live eternally with you. Amen.
Lucas Rodney Leopold. Lucas chose John chapter 3, verse 16 as his confirmation verse. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life.
Lucas Rodney, you have made public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Lucas Rodney, whom you adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and keep him steadfast in your word, that in the end he may be saved and live eternally with you. Amen. Amen.
Sydney Anna Danielle Lowe. Sydney chose Proverbs chapter 3, verses 15 through 18. She's more precious than jewels, and nothing you desire can compare with her. Long life is in her right hand, and her left hand are riches and honor. Her ways are ways of pleasantness, and all her paths are peace. She's a tree of life to those who lay hold of her. Those who hold her fast are called happy.
Sydney, Anna, Danielle, you too have made public profession of your faith. So now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism? And as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Sydney, Anna, Danielle, whom you've adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving. Give her patience in suffering, and keep her steadfast in your word, that in the end she may be saved and live eternally with you.
Brooklyn Ann Merkins. Brooklyn chose Hebrews 11, verse 1. Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen.
Brooklyn Ann, you have made a public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Brooklyn Ann, whom you adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and keep her steadfast in your word, that in the end she may be saved and live eternally with you. Amen.
Zachary Eric Paternus. Zach chose Matthew chapter 6, verse 34. Therefore, do not be anxious about tomorrow, for tomorrow will be anxious for itself. Sufficient for the day is its own trouble.
Zachary Herrick, you have made public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism. And as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer.
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Zachary Eric, whom you've adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience and suffering, and keep him steadfast in your word, that in the end he may be saved and live eternally with you. Amen.
Andrew Valentino Pesavento, you are dead through the trespasses and sins.
Andrew Valentino, you have made public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Andrew Valentino, whom you adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and keep him steadfast in your word, that in the end he may be saved and live eternally with you.
Amen.
Amen.
Aiden Michael Rath. Aiden chose Leviticus 19, verse 2. Speak to all the congregation of the people of Israel, for say to them, you shall be holy, for I, the Lord your God, am holy.
Aiden, Michael, you have made public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Aiden Michael, whom you've adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and keep him steadfast in your word, that in the end he may be saved and live eternally with you. Amen.
Amen.
Malia Marie Rood. Malia chose Jeremiah 29, verse 11. For surely I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. plans for your welfare and not for harm, to give you a future with hope.
Malia Marie, you have made public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Malia Marie, whom you adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and keep her steadfast in your word, that in the end she may be saved and live eternally with you. Amen. Amen.
Annabeth Joan Schiller. Annabeth chose Isaiah 43, verse 2. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you.
Annabeth Joan, you have made public profession of your faith. So now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, and as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Annabeth Joan, whom you've adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and keep her steadfast in your word, that in the end she may be saved and live eternally with you.
Maddox Alexander Schumacher. Maddox chose 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 12. Let no one despise you for your youth, but set the believers as an example in speech, in conduct, in love, in faith, and in purity.
Maddox Alexander, you have made public profession of your faith. So now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism? And as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Maddox Alexander, whom you adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm his faith, guide his life, empower him in his serving, give him patience in suffering, and keep him steadfast in your word, that in the end he may be saved and live eternally with you. Amen. Amen.
Lily Rebecca Soline. Lily chose Romans chapter 12, verse 21. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good.
Lily Rebecca, you have made public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism? And as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Lily Rebecca, whom you've adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and keep her steadfast in your word, that in the end she may be saved and live eternally with you. Amen.
Amen.
Michaela Madison Wakefield. Michaela chose Micah chapter 7, verse 7. But as for me, I will look to the Lord. I will wait for the God of my salvation. My God will hear me.
Michaela Madison, you have made a public profession of your faith, so now I ask you, will you, by the grace of God, continue to live faithfully in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism? And as a member of the church, be committed to hearing God's word, receiving the Lord's Supper, and in prayer?
Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up the gift of the Holy Spirit in Michaela Madison, whom you adopted as your child in holy baptism. Confirm her faith, guide her life, empower her in her serving, give her patience in suffering, and keep her steadfast in your word, that in the end she may be saved and live eternally with you. Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, we thank you for granting these young servants of yours the gift of new life in Christ. As they have confessed their faith in you, now complete the work that you have begun in them. Increase their knowledge of the salvation Christ has won. When they are weak, strengthen them. As they confront a dangerous world, protect them. They will face many temptations, so help them to resist sin and obey your will. In times of struggle or suffering, comfort them. Make them diligent in prayer and faithful in worship. Sustain them by the Holy Spirit, that they, with all your faithful people and before the world, may confess Jesus Christ as Lord, to your eternal glory. Amen. We continue to worship now by receiving our confirmation offering. Mm-hmm.
Let us pray for those who have confirmed their faith and for all Christians everywhere, that they may be redeemed from all evil and rescued from the way of sin and death. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit may open their hearts to your grace and truth. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That they may be kept in the faith and commitment of your holy church. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
That they may be sent into the world in witness to your love. Lord, in your mercy, that they may be brought to the fullness of your peace and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Thank you.
in peace. Serve the Lord.